Hey man, welcome to the Weasel Jones Show, man. I'm the Weasel Jones. Yeah, okay. Welcome to the hottest show on TV, man, where we like to show you the most dangerous, well, not dangerous, dangerous because nobody wants you to see it, man. That's right, we have the best bootlegged videos anywhere on TV. Kabow! Today we've got an awesome video for you, man. Okay, do you remember that serial killer that was called the Farmhouse Slicer? Well, dude, we have a bootlegged video, man, of the crime scene of his last crime. Boo, they said it was a roll of meth, man, but totally not true, man. We got proof today, and we're gonna prove them wrong. Here's a picture of him right here. Yeah, he's a nasty looking bastard, I know. Yeah, that's totally awesome, man. Okay, well, it's totally cool because we got some footage for you, and we're gonna show you some footage of the crime scene and detectives, you know, going over and stuff. And then we actually have the detectives who worked on this case, who caught this bastard. And put his butt in jail, man. And we got them here today, and we're gonna interview them. Okay, watch this footage, man.
Detective Smith. Detective Johnson.
Like I said, I've got the two detectives here. Mr. Detective Smith here. Hey, how's it going, Smith? Man, good to see you, bro. And we also got Detective Johnson over here. Johnson, my man, good to see you. Hey.
Too.
Yeah, thanks, man. Okay, so we're here to talk to them about the case, man. So they really wanted to cover this whole thing up. You know, this slicer guy. He was sick. You know, he went around, he decapitated people, you know, cut the body parts up and leave it like buried somewhere. He was like a dog, man, with a bone. It was crazy. Alright, so tell me, by the footage there, it looks like, you know, this was a pretty sick guy and, you know, what everybody was saying about him. Tell us, how did you pin this guy?
Good old-fashioned police work. In this case, this guy had been going on quite a rampage for a while. And he was getting increasingly more violent. He started off cutting off various body parts, limbs, fingers, and things of that matter. And in the last few cases, we were seeing an escalation in violence. He even went as far as decapitating victims.
Oh, dude.
I know I haven't answered your question yet. We got a break. We didn't really have any eyewitnesses, anything to go by on, anything like that. In this case, he made a few mistakes. He left a couple of latent prints that we were able to identify, but we didn't have anything to match up in the crime file that matched up with the prints.
Yeah.
So it was just a matter of waiting for someone to get arrested and fit the fingerprints, or an eyewitness, or, you know, we just knew we had either to catch him, or things were gonna get really bad.
Yeah, no kidding, man. So what kind of evidence did you find to pin this guy?
We found all kinds of different evidence. Detective Johnson I'll let him speak on behalf of what he found. But what we were able to do, how we were able to link this guy, and the note, which we had, either was a note left on the scene,